Welcome back to another Eleshop video. Today we're going to talk about battery internal impedance, what it is and how to measure it properly. We look at why a regular multimeter isn't suitable for this and we'll show you two popular testers, the Fnirsi HRM-10 and the Hioki BT3554-51. By the end of this video, you know exactly how to test your batteries. Every battery has some internal resistance, also called internal impedance. This represents how easily current can flow through the battery's internal structure. In this schematic, the battery is shown together with a resistor and a capacitor, which together represent its internal impedance. When a battery is new, this resistance is very low. But as the battery ages and degrades, the impedance increases. A higher internal impedance means the battery delivers less current. Its voltage drops faster under load and overall performance decreases. Measuring internal impedance helps us understand the health of a battery. For example, a good 18650 lithium battery typically has an internal impedance of around 20 milliohms. When a cell gets older and wears out, the internal resistance can easily double or triple near the end of its life. You might wonder if you can simply measure the battery's internal impedance with a regular multimeter. First of all, the impedance of a battery is often in the double-digit milliohm range. Most multimeters are not designed to measure such small resistance. On top of that, a multimeter uses a DC signal to measure resistance, but DC doesn't pass the capacitance of the battery, so the measurement will not work. To pass the capacitance in the equivalent battery model, an AC signal is required for the resistance measurement. Battery manufacturers specify internal impedance using a 1 kHz AC signal. The tester applies a small alternating voltage to the battery, measures the resulting current, and calculates the impedance. This method is fast. You get an accurate reading in less than a second. It's also the industry standard, which means the numbers you measure match the values given in most battery data sheets. There is an additional challenge when measuring impedance. The impedance is most often just a few milliohms, so extremely small. So often, the resistance of your cables or clamps will be higher than the value you're trying to measure. That's why proper impedance testers use a 4-wire measurement. Two wires inject the test voltage and two separate wires measure the current. This method eliminates the resistance of the leads and contacts, giving you a precise and repeatable result. Let's take a closer look at two examples to show you the difference between an entry-level tester and a professional-grade model. The Fnirsi HRM-10 is a great entry-level tester for occasional measurements in small businesses. It's affordable, easy to use, and works for batteries up to 100 volts. This makes it perfect for checking individual cells or small battery packs. The Hioki BT3554-51 is a high-end professional tester. It is extremely accurate and supports automated measurements. It's designed for testing large numbers of batteries quickly and reliable, making it ideal for professional environments where consistency is critical. So if you need something simple and budget-friendly, the Fnirsi is an excellent choice. But if you want industrial level accuracy and detailed documentation, The Hioki is the ultimate tool. Let's quickly demonstrate the testing of a battery. First, we measure a 12-volt 7-amp-hour battery using the Fnirsi HRM-10 in our colleague's scooter. You can see the display shows the internal resistance in milliohms and the battery voltage at the same time. We measure 14 milliohms and 13 volt DC, which is great since this is a new battery. Now, let's measure this old battery. This one is a 12 volts 6 amp hour battery. Here we measure 35.8 milliohm, indicating that this battery is indeed at the end of its life. So, in conclusion, a regular multimeter simply won't give you accurate results. But a battery tester, which uses a 1 kHz AC signal with 4 wire clamps, will. We offer a wide range of battery impedance testers in our webshop, for both small businesses and industrial applications. Let us know in the comments, do you already measure your batteries? And if so, which tester do you use? Want to learn more? Visit the Eleshop knowledge base, where you find detailed articles and videos on testing and measuring, like our video about how you can measure mains voltages with an oscilloscope. Thanks for watching.